Welcome back. It is time for Operation Dying Smoke. This is an alien terror attack in Bangalore, India, on the rooftop cafe map. This can be a very, very punishing map, depending on where you spawn. I could, you know, spend 2 minutes talking to you about all the different spawns, or I could just hit launch. We could find out which spawn we're in, and I'll tell you about that one in particular. Also, look how great the knee pads are on that armor. I just love this game. It's so well done. Anyway, let's get down there and let's see what LZ we're going to have on Operation Dying Smoke.
Central, Strike 1 is locked and loaded. Awaiting drop orders.
Affirmative, Big Sky. Squad is cleared to engage hostile targets. Watch your fire out there. We have civilians on the ground. Repeat, civilians are in the AO.
Hello, I'd like to order one taxi fare driver. Yes, yes. Oh, destination? Anywhere that isn't fucking here? Yes, thank you. Oh, I'm sorry. There is no driver. I'm just gonna stand here and wait for XCOM to save me. So this is the original LZ of this map. This is the vanilla LZ. This is probably the worst LZ for this map. Isn't it funny how those two things coincide? This is probably the most dangerous LZ you can get for this map. Do I even need to explain it? It's because you start in very shitty cover. Not only do you have very limited cover... Let's go down the checklist. All your cover can explode. That's a no-no. You don't want that. Your cover's shitty because most of it is half cover. That's also a no-no. Your cover is easily flankable and you can easily get caught in a crossfire because you're in a cross section of the map from left and right. Oh, I got flanked from the left from this great truck. Oh, I got flanked from the right, but fucking all this shit. Great. The first turn on this map is hell. If you make contact on your first turn, you're fucked. Luckily, you generally don't make contact on your very first turn. Usually it's your second. Usually the game has a little bit of mercy for you and it's your second turn. That kind of allows you to get set up in this really shitty cover. Now, what I want to do here is I'm going to assume that a map this small, packed with contact on a terror mission, I'm going to hit contact at least on my second move, if I'm not lucky, my first. I want to get Organ and EQ in position on this half-cover car. They're my squad siders with Javelin and squad sight sniper rifle. Phew! Firing down this alleyway. If I take contact on the left as I do that, tough fucking luck. That's going to be terrible. The swearing is starting early on this mission because this map is really tough. Sorry. Cell, meanwhile, will take the next best position, which is going to be squad sight, five tile squad sight on this van. Next from that, the squad will start to move to the right, and we're going to get into the cover that is marginally not as shitty. If you go left, you have literally no cover. There is nothing here. There's just a whole section where it's like, just fuck you. as if, you know, Ananda Gupta or Jake Solomon were just like, you know, the lead level designers like, all right, so I haven't really finished the map. There isn't any cover here. And Jake Solomon and Ananda both just look at each other and then they stare him dead in the eye. They're like, don't even worry about it. I like it better this way. So don't go that way. Instead, we're going to go to the right. We've got a little bit better cover, but again, it's very easily flankable. It's all explodable. It's all half cover. Scoobman will set up his infantry rifle on the corner. You're going to see assaults charging forward with Zim, scout charging forward. On our first turn, we're going to chuck a scan to try and see what's awaiting us because we know stuff will be awaiting us. And the general idea is just static elements remaining here in support, mobile elements charging up into slightly better position. If we get caught in a horrific activation, I have to remember that I have the ghost grenades on DSM, and that can bail us out of two bad turns, which is really something to not be underestimated. If I get a terrible activation on Organ at the start here, I can bail myself out of the bad turn with the ghost grenade. If I get a terrible activation on first turn on the right, I can bail myself out. So that's the general idea. We're using the ghost grenades as goats in the hole. Other than that, squad sight, moving up, assaulting, and moving fast. Hello? Yes, see, there's a guy named this back there in the background there. He's like, hello, yes, I'd like a taxi too. And then this guy up here is also like, I'd like a taxi out of the city. I'm sorry, you're a pot of flowers. I don't know what came over me. I'm so sorry. But gosh, you smell nice. I just want to see him like on his turn, just jump in here to hide. So first things first, I'll be setting up Organ to the left.
On my way.
How wonderful. No contact on my left immediately. Next, I will be moving Instinct up to, let's say here.
Solid copy.
No contact on both sides. This is incredible. This is amazing.
Hey, boy.
I can't believe it. This is wonderful. Can I set up Cell even?
Moving.
Wow. What a great turn. This Terra mission is just looking up.
Aye,
guys, it's just looking great. Okay. I'm gonna chuck a lovely little scanner over here. And I just want a lovely little picture of what is happening up the street and also interior of the building here.
Eyes in the sky.
The battle scanner is an underappreciated and overpowered tool, in my opinion. Now, I've got a cyber disc there we can see. And his little drone cohort. Oh, that is a tiny little disc. I get used to the big long war boss cyber discs, and I see something like this, and my eyes adjust to it. It's like, is that an Oreo? Like, is that a cute little, like a little cat saucer? Am I going to put milk in that and feed it to my... No, that's a cyber disc. That's... My god, look at it. Those... It's just so tiny. Apparently it also can't fly. The drones are trying to lift it, much like slaves would lift, like, an old hedonistic Greek emperor, you know, just... hedonistic Greek noble just carrying him around on his chair. The drones are just flying that cyber disc around, so I'm going to assume it's crippled. Now I'm going to move to get in the position here, because obviously we want to be ready for this thing next turn, because we're about to activate it. I can chuck another scan with Maple, which is a wonderful opportunity that I will take full advantage of here.
I'm on it, Commander.
Let's clear our left side of this scan and find out what we could be facing on the left. Because that in itself is a very, very important distinction right now to make. We want to position this so the scan could see in through the window properly, while also seeing the rest of the map if possible. There we go. There's your scan.
Eyes open.
And what do we have? What have you got at the end of the day? Let's pull out my Close Encounters Assault Instinct. And let's look for the orange circles. I have not revealed anything extra with that scan. Nothing down the street that I can see. But it's good to have that flank security. And when you've got this many scans, why not take advantage of them, really? Steady that rocketeer. And everyone, just get ready. Yes.
Overwatch.
Yes, yes, yes. Now let's see if the disc makes the first move. Okay, I lied. He can fly. He doesn't need the drones at all. It's all a mistake. Okay, now here comes some more fun. We've got a... That's not quite a chrysalid boss, but I'd say it's like a chrysalid uncle. It's a slightly bigger chrysalid. It's like a chrysalid cousin. Oh! My God! Ah! Ah! Oi! Oh, excuse me. It's Lidzilla! Oh my god, it's Lidzilla! Oh my god, it's Lidzilla! Oh god! Of course, this would be a very special mission with the aliens just throwing everything they can against me right now. Oh my god. That's disgusting! Okay, we're facing Lidzilla right now. Get a good look at that, Big Mama. This is the Chrysalid Queen, and she is angry. Can I get a readout on her perks? Potentially. Maybe Cell can get a readout. No, I have nothing in range, so I can't start the attack action. Okay, well, that's a thing. Now, this is probably going to patrol into me next turn. So I would say we do not want to deal with this thing while there is a cyber disc. We want to focus all our efforts on this queen. Now, you know what that means? I'm going to need to count because I need to see exactly when I'm going to come in sight range of this thing, of this monstrosity, and that's going to be 1, 2, 3. Is that really a three-tile hatchback? 1, 2, it really is, okay. So it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. That guy hiding behind the counter like, oh my god, what the fuck, Long War? What the fuck, Johnny Lum? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Now, if I go purely by vision, I will be in sight as soon as the soldier is at this position. However, I may be able to use this truck to sneak closer. No, I will not. So, once again, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So I will probably draw aggro before I get in range there. So perhaps what I might want to do instead is hold what I've got and just bring my squad back to be ready here. If I hold where I am with Cell, Cell's gonna have sight on these fuckers. If I bring Petite a bit back, Petite should be ready to chuck grenades and shit. Which is going to be very useful.
Aye, aye, Commander.
And I just have to pray that the Cyberdisc fucks off while I fuck on this Chrysalid Queen.
Heading there now.
And we're just going to have to try and focus our squad's efforts hugely here. We absolutely just want to completely focus our efforts on this one boss.
Ich mach mich los.
Because it is not a trifling matter what we're dealing with right here. And I may even want to go so far as to bring Cell back to this position where I'm not going to draw the Cyberdisc as easily. Because that would be a very poor thing to have happen.
That's affirmative.
Right now. Even though it lowers the amount of Overwatch fire she can put out, I really do not want that Cyberdisc to activate on me. So, we'll go Hunker. Oh my god. Probably move up to be in closer range for the close encounters. That thing might have shock absorbent armor. It probably has shock absorbent armor. I'm going to throw... I can't throw a scan up on the roof. I want to clear that roof. I'm just going to Overwatch. I wish I'd hit and run on that scout right now. You'll be able to throw the scan, though. I'm going to throw a scan. Won't you? Okay, I can't get a scan up on that roof. Okay, it's fine. Never mind, then. I am just going to get ready for the fun to begin. So yeah, aim. So I get a beautiful shot on the Chris next round. We don't want it to miss. Steady my aim for another beautiful shot. Overwatching. And I hope it paths into me this turn because I want to... Oh, God. I want to engage it, like, now, before the disc comes back. Oh, Christ. And I hear mech out there. Give me the wide-angle view of that thing. And mutons. There is so much on this map. It is a frightening map to be on. Here it comes. Oh, my God! It moves so quickly! It has lightning reflexes! Oh, that thing moves so quickly! Shouldn't it move slower because it's big? Oh god, no, get away from me. I think I killed one of them. Because I think there's like two Chrysalids just ran off safe. This might work in our favor because we can totally focus down the Mama right now. The Mama has charged my position and it is massive. That is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 health. And let's look at the perks. Please don't have shock absorbent. This thing has shock absorbent and scuba's right next to it. Oh my god, it's huge. It has sprinter, lightning reflexes, it of course has hardened. It has a 15% inbuilt defense. Really, you're going to miss this thing? I guess it's pretty fast. Adaptive bone marrow. Well, I'm going to kill it this turn, so fuck that. Leap, venomous claws, implant, and shock absorbent. So not actually that many perks. Thank fucking god. We're just going to kill the shit out of this thing. Now, I really want to shred this before I do anything else. Because even with all this firepower, I am not taking any fucking chances with this piece of shit. So we're going to go with an early shredder here. Just got to make sure it doesn't hit my troops who aren't in cover. So we'll do a nice little shredder there. I might even move Zim further back first. Just to make sure no one's getting shredded here. We want to be out of that four tower range anyway. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I move back, like, a tile. That's all gravy, baby. We're going to take this nice, accurate shredder rocket here. We just want to make sure that it does not hit any of our troops because that would be bad. We just want the shredder property applied. Whatever else happens, it doesn't matter too much. Just want to cook up this shredder on the target.
Target locked.
Hello, fuck you. We're not going to bother chemming because it is... It is, of course, chem immune because it is a chrysalid. And now we are going to apply holo-targeting next. When you're fighting a boss like this, much like fighting an MMO, like raid boss, you want to make sure you've got all your debuffs stacking nicely. That said, if this goes wrong, I would probably also really want Ghost Grenade. So maybe I won't even bother with the holo-targeting. Maybe I'll just say, oh, you know what, if we don't kill it this turn, I'm gonna ghost grenade myself, because fuck you. So, we're gonna go rapid fire. And just lay all firepower into this monstrosity. I think we should be fine, simply because this thing charged us alone without its brood. Obviously, if we'd been fighting a Cyberdisc or its little nestlings had come with it right now, we'd be in a lot more trouble because we have to focus so much fire on it. But, luckily the little children ran off, to fight, to eat little baby civilians, so we're kind of blessed in that sense. I'm gonna move up with Instinct. Imagine if this thing had covering fire CCS, so if you ran up to it, it got a free hit at you. Ugh. Okay, we're gonna take Shredded Alloy Cannon Shot. The shred should kind of cancel out the shock absorbent a little bit, I hope, and make the damage decent. Now, can I still even ghost, or did I just... No, I can still ghost, that's fine. I can still ghost at this point. Engage. This monstrosity. 9 damage, that's pretty good. Let's keep wearing it down here.
That's affirmative.
Oops, I just moved into 4 tiles. That's silly. That was silly of me. Let's just engage now. Oh, of course, Cell doesn't have double tap. I just see LMG and I assume double tap. But that's okay. Because now Iku is going to claim this prize for himself. You are one ugly motherfucker. Oh my god. That was a nice crit, Iku. So that is one of the bigger ragdolls you're ever going to see in XCOM. You throw a bit of seasoning in there, chuck a bone in, baby. You got a stew going with that. That's going to feed a lot of people. Wow, that is massive. Okay, I'm going to take a reload round. Throw another scan out to keep tabs on what's happening inside the building. Because we've still got live chrysalids out there. It's just they all ran off. And if they had charged me, this would have been a scary turn. Can I see any of the live ones? No, so we'll hold our fire.
Back in.
Reload.
Solid copy.
And probably check another scan over to the left. Keep tabs on that those lids as well. And yes. I'm really glad that thing just charged. Because if it had just run off or anything else, wouldn't have been very fun. Now let's see what happens. We should have, like... Okay, here comes the Cyberdisc. Didn't actually activate on me this turn, which is very interesting. Ah, shit. Sectopods. 1, 2, 3 lids off in the distance in that pod. We've got, like, 1, 2, 3, I think. Maybe just 1, 2 live lids on the left. Sectopod is coming. With a Seeker and a drone. It's walking off, thank Christ. This is why they were saving money of all the sectoid abductions. This is a very strong terror. Hello, little buddy. Okay, so we got 3 live chrysalids. My intuition was correct there. Rip you. You should have run probably late. Oh, that's a lady. That guy did run. Wow, he's a genius. No, wait. No, he's not, because he's about to die as well. Rip you also. And we have a rapidly developing zombie problem, which we're going to want to put a stop to. Plus, there's a muton bot out there. We heard that. We definitely heard that. I may want to simply activate the disc right now and just deal with it before the sector pod or any mutons hit me. We should be able to take care of that thing. Oh, actually, with Cell not in proper position... It might be better to not activate the disc this turn. There's no reason to activate the disc this turn. Because AWO, not AWO, Superman can take care of that. Cell can take care, actually. They can both take care of that. So that's a bit wasted. We'll see how my shots go. We'll see whether... I can disable the disc, worst case. Oh, no, I can't disable the disc. No, the wall will blow open. I should be able to disable it. We'll see how we can chain our inner zone here. If we can chain the inner zone properly, it might be wise to just take this fucker out. Take this shit out. So I just know Stella's going to mulch this thing on her own. Tear it up.
Nailed him.
That is one lid down as I try to keep my different tokens clear here. Next, we've got a couple of... Well, fuck, I can shred both of them. It seems like a fun time to me, to be quite honest. Just means I'm going to shred a left for the sector pod then, though, is something I got to keep in mind. Maybe I'll just take a standard rocket. And then save the shredder for the sector pod. I don't know why I keep saying it won't deal any damage, but that disturbs me. I kind of need it to deal damage. And it's kind of... I don't know why it's doing that. Maybe it's a sign that I should not. There we go. But it seems to just be when my rocketeer leaves the zone. That's very strange. I don't know what's happening there. I'm sure it's just a graphical glitch, though. It makes no sense. Maybe we'll save both the rocket and just engage the lid this turn. I don't know. I'm kind of torn on what I want to do here. Exactly. Nah, because to move in... Otherwise, I just let the chrysalids keep making zombies. Let's engage on it this turn. If this rocket will fucking let me engage. Let's spiral a rocket right into there. Should definitely hit the disc, and if not, it should blow up some bullshit at the very least. I'm getting the camera doing its own thing right now, which I hate when that happens. But let's spiral that rocket over towards this pod, which I'm honestly about to activate anyway, so it's better to get this out of the way early on.
Bring in the pain.
Okay, this is an interesting day already. Maybe that's what he was trying to tell me. You don't want to fire the rocket. It is what I'm getting out of this, organ. Really? You just don't want to fire the rocket? Okay, I'm going to try again. Prep. Azimuth. Okay. What is happening? I've never had a soldier just refuse to follow my orders like this before. I don't know what's happening. God damn it, I gave you an order, organ. What the? Fuck it. This is going really weird. I guess I can't fire the rocket this turn. This is getting really strange. I guess we'll have to come around the left side here and hope.
On my way.
That's very weird, organ. I don't know how to feel about that, to be quite honest with you. I'm not particularly happy about that.
In Bewegung.
But I guess I can't engage the Cyberdisc this turn by that notion. Wow, this is a really weird turn. I guess I'm going to move you and try and steady my aim and see if that helps.
Heading out.
Or even need, I could have fired on that lid, but never mind, it's too late now.
Moving out.
I'll move in with Petite. This is very weird indeed. Start moving around the side with DSM here. I guess. No, let's take a shot. Take a shot with DSM. Wonderful.
No way that
Magnifique. Perfect. That should put it firmly in the range of fun for are you shitting me? Okay, Iku can't see that one. This is an interesting turn. Let us instead just fucking shoot that one then, I guess. The one I can see. And I could have in the zone chained, but it's all in the past now. Actually, 5, 6, 7, that wouldn't even change. There you go. It's all in the past now. Overwatch. Don't even know sometimes with this game. Reload, reload. And the Cyberdisc will probably move into me this turn anyway. There are zombies. Not a very action-packed turn, and the chrysalids can run. Oh, what the fuck is happening? Oh, and they get a turn! Wow, this is a fascinating round. Am I going to get shot out of no cover here by the disc? Am I going to get grenaded behind my half-cover car? What an interesting round. Sector pod's coming back. We're going to want to not activate that. The disc is on the move. Oh, fuck. Doesn't seem to have another action, though. And I just need to be ready for anything on this mission, it seems. Here comes the lids. Scuba shouldn't have any problem. Oh, God. There's a fucking giant limb in my way. I can't see, Commander. It's still there. That's right, I shot through it. Okay. Unfortunately, that means this lid still a problem. But he's going to trigger the ire of instinct. Who will act on instinct and quite easily pierce the heavens with his allocannon there. Now I have two zombies to keep track of. Plus an interesting number of contacts coming into my position, including a very interesting looking sector pod. The big daddy of the robotics world. And I don't mean he's got a drill on his arm, I mean literally he is the grandfather of robotics. Okay, two zombies are coming in against me. Cell not in position against this disc. That's unfortunate. But my rocket is ready and hopefully will not completely fuck up for no reason this round. So we'll fire that. What am I hitting? Oh, we'll fire that. What am I hitting? I'm gonna need a battle scanner nonetheless. We'll chuck a scan with Petite because I need that battle scanner to reveal for the sniper shot follow-up from Iku. So we'll chuck a scanner onto this desk. Scanner's getting a lot of work in this operation. There's that disc, which we needed anyway. Which we needed side of anyway. Now the rocket. Now I can see the civilians. I see. So it's wedged in between a pair of civilians is the problem. Well, that's all right. I'll just place the rocket right here, and it should be fine. We'll fire that shredder rocket with no regrets. Going hard. With the recoilless rifle here. Ah, devastation. Did you hear that really satisfying noise? It sounded a little different from usual. Oh my god. The absolute devastation. Yes! I'm sorry, Cyberdisc? Never heard of it. Get out of here. And that pod is gone in the blink of an eye. Ha 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 ha! Ha 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 ha! Ha ha ha! And this should be all current contact going down the drain right now. That's one zombie down, never forget. And here comes the next. Fucking magnificent. Hell, I think I can go one step further here. Oh no, in the zone doesn't trigger pistols, that's so sad. I was gonna in the zone with a pistol and then reload, and that would have just been an MLG round if ever I've seen one, but sadly not to be. Instead, where is that sector pod exactly? Will that trigger? You've got a sector pod and his little seeker buddy. The seeker at 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, so I should be able to move to this position. Take out this zombie and then retreat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. It should be fine if I just move to this position.
Get in there now.
No activations necessary. Hit. The zombie is deceased, and like that, the dirt is gone. Now, I kind of want to watch out. I don't even want to reload. I just want to fall back to make sure I don't get free activated. Just like that mechanized Cyberdisc pod just activated on me for free there. I don't want to get free activated by the fucking sector pod. So I might just hold what I've got. Move Scuba up even. Probably move Instinct back so everyone's in cover because I don't trust things anymore after that Cyberdisc could have killed someone if it wanted to. we will fall back into cover on the right.
We'll go.
Instinct is going to bury himself in the... just going to give some kisses to the giant corpse there, who's giving him a big old hug. Isn't that cute? He's just covered in kaiju guts right now. Move up with a Zim. Overwatch and reload. And what a turn it has been.
Let's do this.
And we've got a muton pod out there, don't forget. So I'm going to use my Fillmore the bus from Cars domino, collectible domino, to mark the sector pod as a token. Come. Here come the lids. Three lids in play. I'm going to place my Dory the Fish commemorable domino on the field to remind me that there's a muton pod out there. Now we've got three chrysalids to deal with right here. A couple of them at long range, difficult to get eyes on. And here comes the football team. How many mutons are we looking at here? What an interesting mission. They really just pulled everything off the alien rack this time. Looks like just a pair of mutons, which is surprisingly merciful considering the other pace of this mission. That doesn't fit the theme at all. It's just like, hey, Glopthrax. Rickabum. Rickabum. You got a really shitty name, by the way, Rickabum. Shut up, Glopthrax. Listen, I'm gonna go down to the terror mission. You wanna come? Yeah, that sounds like a lot of fun. We're gonna bring my plasma rifle, and we're gonna shoot some XCOM. Yeah, that's all we should need, really. I don't think we need to bring anything else. And then they get in the UFO, they get in the assault carrier, and they're just like looking around like, hey, Rickathrax. Glob Zoom. Yeah, there's like 10 chrysalids, and that one's like the size of my mother. And it's like, yeah, that one is really big. What is that robotic monstrosity? I think it's a sectopod. I saw those on the catalog. Those are just coming off the factory line. This is going to be a hell of a mission. Zappaboom. That's right, Rickabong. That's how I imagined these two muton buddies just showed up on this mission, despite being really shitty compared to everything else. Anyway, back to the mission. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Do not cut this corner. Do not pass go. Do not go in front of this chrysalid here. But we need to pick off those guys who are off in the distance there. So I move into position.
That's affirmative.
Perfect. I can close encounters this one. Sell. Gonna save me a bit of trouble over here with this little lid. Cell just can't stop rapid firing chrysalids, and it is a thing of beauty, make no mistake. We're gonna alloy cannon. You're actually a free kill at this point. I can reload against you practically. You're probably a free kill. You're not definitely a free kill, but you're probably a free kill. I'm gonna move up with Scuba Man. See if I can get some damage on the other one. I can't, which is unfortunate. The other one can kind of do whatever it wants over there, and there's not really a lot I have to say about it. Unless I can get a laser pistol to hit. Here's Big Iku in control. Iku's gonna take a shot. Wonderful. Watch out, sir. I've splayed chrysalid all over you. I'm so sorry. We're going to need to deal some damage with our laser pistol if we want to have any hope of in the zoning or killing even that other one. But that is another lid down. I can spiral that token off. No one else can get inside here without cutting the corner in a very bad way. So I'm going to take a laser pistol shot. It's a start, man. It is a start. Everybody's going to start somewhere. We're going to take our shot with Iku. It's very unlikely to kill, but it's a start. Very unlikely to even hit, apparently.
Damn it.
It's fine.
Enemy is still alive.
I have no other option. I'm just going to overwatch. And prepare myself for the majesty that is the sector pod that is moving into range quicker and quicker, coming for me. Gonna overwatch.
Shield, commander.
Reload, I guess. Steady that rocket because we're gonna need that real bad. And overwatch. Sorry, lady. Couldn't really do much for ya. Oh, it's three mutons. I was being tricked. Okay, so three mutons just entered the field. And Scoobman continues to struggle with the concept of aliens who can dodge fire with their inbuilt defense. Now, the sector pod activating on me at this point would be very poor. Luckily, that little guide rail is going to stop him from activating on me, so that is very handy. And the crystal is just going to restore all the damage I dealt to it, which is a good move from him. I think that's a very good move from him. Now, Instinct has an easy flank, but again, cutting that corner could have disastrous results. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Yes, we do not want to go past this lamp. That is going to have some very unwelcome results that no one will be happy with. What can Scoobman do? Scoobman can engage the muton. Sail can't really do anything. Sail can move to the right to try and help deal that lid. Whatever happens, I'm going to move to this position, I think. Let's move to this position first. Now, I have a flank. He hasn't got a great chance to hit, but it is better than a slap in the face. Sail cannot really do anything from her current position, but she can prepare herself for next turn. And meanwhile, what will the rest of us do? Iku, if he takes a shot, needs to guarantee that he can reload by the end of this turn so that he can then continue firing on the sector pod when it makes its reveal, which is probably going to be next turn, if not sooner. Probably just going to want to lock and load an Overwatch with Scooby. Scooby-dooby-doo. Which means I really need to hit this thing. Yeah, not bad. Now I think we can deal that easy 7. And there's the 10. And there's the 10. Okay, we're still preparing that shot. That beautiful, beautiful shot. I might even give up that position because it's going to be slightly better positioning for what is to come.
Moving.
Good to go.
Reload.
Oh, yeah.
Roger, keep that shredder prepped. We'll see if we can get Petite into position to chuck grenades over this truck. I had a feeling the arc wouldn't be that good, but it's better than nothing. You know, it's better than nothing else. And she can take the sides next turn to chuck grenades over. That's all good. Zim can probably do the opposite and probably cross over.
Okay.
To suppress this fucko right here. You can suppress him. Help take him down. And also dissuade him from just sitting still, of course. We're going to lock and load an Overwatch. Reload. And I suppose, I don't know, maybe launch a mind fray here. Seems like a fun opportunity. There you go, that might be the first effective psychic use of a power to date, of an offensive psychic power in this campaign. There you go. Now the zombies are coming back to haunt us. Where was the other zombie? Was there two? Did I not keep track of the zombies? There's only one. That's not close enough to Instinct, is it? Surely not. That's so far away. Well, it doesn't matter. It's going to take all my damn Overwatch anyway. Fucking thing. No. I needed that Overwatch on the side. Okay, well, the zombie is dead. At least I got the suppression, I guess. Fuck. I needed to kill him right here with that maneuver. But he's mind frayed. He's out. He's like, oh my god, fuck this. He's gonna tag in his buddy, I feel. Oh my god. That poor civilian is stuck in the window. And every day that the sector pod does not activate is a good day, as it just kind of stares there. Angrily, I suppose. Now, where is your little buddy? You're just standing in the open there, or is that a pillar? That's a pillar. Where is his little buddy? That seemed like it was a point blank. Close range, but I don't know where that monstrosity is, or indeed what he is doing. Well, I can move into corner cover here regardless.
Heading to that location.
Get eyes in the whole affair. Or not get eyes in the whole affair, as the case may be. That guy's sitting out in the open. He does not give any shits. He should. You will be afraid. You will be. That's not going to cut the corner on the sectopods. That's fine.
Aye, aye.
No eyes, though, which sucks. So I can't really do anything to these mutons this turn. Oh, no, I tell a lie. I can run and gun up into... That's not cover. Okay. I can't really do anything, as I was saying, to these mutons this turn because it would leave me far too exposed to a flank on my right side. I could, of course, charge in on the this side, but I can't spot him with my next left... Oh, that is him. Oh, that's not a pillar. That is him.
Moving to firing position.
Go with God instinct.
Okay.
I knew he was there. I saw it, but then I tile scan. I was like, maybe he isn't. Now, the problem is if this doesn't kill, it's leaving me open to reprisals. Fuck it. It's leaving me open to reprisals.
I'm all out.
Which means DSM is going to have to overwatch me here. But it does leave me open to certain reprisals. I'm probably just going to sit still with Cell and overwatch because of those reprisals. But I should be able to put Scoopman in position on here. That should be okay. Yeah, no problem. I mean, I could even go so far as to ghost myself if I wanted. The ghost instinct over there. Because if this guy gets real ballsy, he'll charge out behind me, take the taxi, and instinct does have resilience. So actually, I care even less than I was about to care. Okay, that's good. I actually care significantly less now. That's really good. That's really good that you have instinct, buddy. So we'll move Cell into position.
Heading to that location.
Move Eco into position.
Roger that.
Move Organ up. And what are we going to do with you, Petite?
On the move.
Just stay ready for that sector pod, which might just be stuck next to a guide rail at this point. Impressively enough.
Affirmative, covering now. Roger that. Scanning.
Observator, Comandante.
Alright. Your move. Has the sector pod finally freed itself from its embarrassing prison? Oh, it's just teasing the rim of line of sight right now. Here comes a muton. Taking the overwatch I intended to cover instinct. Which is unfortunate, make no mistake. He's gonna take a shot at Scuba, but that is the Mindfraid one. I can't hit the fucker. Doesn't make it any easier to hit him, but he should have minus 25 aim. Which might be a thank God moment there. Rip you. And he's running. He's scared. He's a little pansy. He might kill this guy in the shorts. I don't know. No, he's just a little pansy. He's just fleeing the scene of the crime. That's A-okay with me. Don't worry about it. Now, we know they've all shot. As long as we continue to not activate the angry little sector pods, we're golden and we're having a good time right here. So if I continue to move in...
Moving. I've got a visual.
That is a load of bullshit.
Go, go, go.
There was a drone in the cafe. No, no. Shit. Sector pod on the roof. Sector pod on the roof. We can't engage the sector pod. It's on the roof. Oh, fuck. No, that's so bad for every reason. Woo. That is dig dang terrible. Let me tell you what. That is not a good no. That's very bad. I think we have to pop some ghosts here. It's the only way to get out of this one. Oh my god. That is singularly terrible. Okay, I can rapid fire this guy, which might deal with him, and I think I'm just gonna have to like ghost myself in this position. Hopefully it rears its ugly head at me next turn. But if I ghost, then I can't battle scan. Yuck. Yuck, yuck, yuck. But I have no other choice. I'm gonna have to run in blind on what that sector pod's doing up there. Unless I run someone of ghost up there. But who would be crazy enough to do that, really? But okay, if I stay in position here, I need to fight my way through these mutons, is the thing. because that sector pod is going to be coming. And it's not going to be fun for anyone who's sticking around when it gets here. I can ghost everyone around the taxi. So that's all good. And we're going to be making excessive use of that. Everyone else over here, not so much. Can't ghost them so much. Wow, that's real bad. Okay, so really all I'd be getting out of the ghost is probably a double tap from Cell. Maybe I can just move Cell back in Hunker instead. I can kind of move DSM around the side here, perhaps. And maybe throw a scan up somehow. I need to get a scan. Here we go, maybe I can... No. I need to get a scan while leaving DSM alive is the caveat to that. I need to get a scan that keeps tabs on that sector pod really dearly. But again, I have to stay alive for it to prove useful. So maybe if I move to this position, I'll be able to throw a scan.
Copy that.
Because of the slight outcropping. Maybe I won't. This gets interestinger and interestinger.
I'm rolling.
What an interesting round. I think I saw another drone too, because that was the one that's tricked me. So Instinct might just have to fall back here, because he's not going to have any fun in his present position. Yes, we may just have to fall back Instinct.
Affirmative.
He's not having any fun there. Yeah, interesting round already. I'm going to probably have to hunker. Even hunkering Iku there is probably too dangerous. I don't know. Organ position is probably a little bit more okay. Maybe just charge Iku, like, away. That should be, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It should be more than fine to just run Iku far, far away.
Orders confirmed.
And exploit squad site in that fashion. Everyone needs to get heavy cover. Nothing less will do against a sector pod. And we're going to have to abandon these positions next turn. Oh, God. We're going to have to abandon these positions next turn, and there's just nothing good happening right now. Nothing good at all happening right now. And now we become very reactive. We lose the initiative.
We're green to go.
Everything that is happening is very bad. Particularly those mutons still in play. Oh, thank God they're just... charging me.
Incoming fire.
They're angry. That's the one I mind frayed, I think. I think he's still feeling the effects. Okay. They're charging me. But they're killing civs. Little bastards. Here comes Sexapod. In control of the situation. Not gonna reveal himself to me this turn, which, again, is not super good, because I cannot disable the enemy I cannot see. So, I've got my thoughts on that being not so hot. Now, we still want to stay hold down as much as we can against the threat that's incoming. I should be able to engage that. No problem. And Scuba should hopefully be able to kill this as well. Not quite. But he's going to resist that panic, no problem. Now I can move in. If only I had hit and run, I could kill both. But I can close the count as one and then finish off the other one. Shouldn't be a big deal.
Got it covered.
Hello, my friends. There's a muton most definitely dealt with. I can probably even stay in this position and reload the alloy cannon at this point. And just aim to fight that muton with Instinct next turn. Should be able to take out the drone. Maybe even the Seeker within the zone, and then just keep prepping myself. Keep stealing my nerves for the incoming onslaught of mechanical power. That is, yeah, bringing itself to me. Hopefully
position.
I can get a scan on it this turn. Ah, there it is! That's why I didn't move to this ladder, because I was deathly afraid of exactly this happening. Now, I can't. Oh my, see. Now I kind of have also some problems because I kind of have to assume he just launched an artillery barrage because I didn't get to see what he did. So I have to just assume it's an artillery barrage and leave it at that. I don't really get to find out what he did. So I'm probably going to do is run here, cloak myself. The point is I need to abandon all my old positions and take new ones, essentially. While also still staying the fuck away from getting booped by him. Now, no one had to sign on petite, so maybe she won't get artilleryed. I'm trying to see who can afford to take this position. No one can even see the fucker from here, actually. No one was on this hatchback, so from the hatchback I can probably take a shot. It'd be very helpful if EQ could in the zone a pair of these fuckos. Like, in the zone that guy. Yep. See, that's a good start. Now in the zone that fucko. Please. Yeah, you get that.
I'll get him next time.
Okay, so we're going to have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, I'm not going to be able to get eyes on him. Which is muy unfortunato. Very unfortunate. So instead, I'll come around the left side.
On the move.
Focus on that engagement instead. I'm going to stick Zim in this position. Now, I believe I took the AP ammo on Zim. No, I took a medkit. So my choices are flush, standard shots, probably with Gauss heat. I could almost afford to flush this fucko. That's going to be a lot of damage. Rapid fire is probably going to miss twice. That's probably going to miss. Its aim bonuses are too strong. Let's just flush it. Let's just flush this fucko. Not enough damage. And that leaves me in a very unfortunate position because it means I need to overwatch here. Scoopman's just going to have to hold position. Which means Cell's going to have to hold position because if I mean, the problem is the Seeker can move and probably hit Iku now. Which I cannot allow, obviously. That would be a bad state of affairs. It's just unfortunate. Not a lot to do at this position. I'm going to chuck a grenade over at this guy. Maybe blow his cover apart. Who knows? Or can I even get a heat grenade up on this drone? No, sadly, I can't. So I'm just going to chuck a grenade on this guy. Try and fuck with him.
Frag out.
I don't know that that sector pod is prepping an arty barrage. I'm just assuming. Because I'm paranoid. And if it is, I don't really want to be where it lands, so being paranoid may be a good idea in this scenario. It usually is. If only it told me. But with these two threats, which can both get eyes on Iku, I kind of have just to assume that it didn't arty barrage, I think. Because anything else is just going to be too unsafe for the other reason. Too unsafe for different reasons. Okay, we're gonna reload. The sector bot could actually flank you if it wanted to, so maybe you should actually just leave. Just fucking leave that position and just get out of it. I know you want to reload. I know you want to reload really bad. I want you to reload too, but you kind of can't right now. You don't really have that option. In that case, maybe I'll take a shot with Cell. Because Cell can easily wipe that thing out. No problem at all.
Flush him out.
If I'm staying in cover with one person, I may as well stink over everyone. This doesn't make any sense otherwise. Except putting all my eggs in one basket. I might want to move Organ. You can't really move to any better position. We'll just have to hunker, overwatch, and hunker. Please don't artillery barrage me. You couldn't see any of my troops. Surely not going to artillery barrage me. I'm just being paranoid, right? Ow, fuck you. Fuck you. Covering fire supremacy.
Enemigos pacificados. Se me está acabando la munición.
I don't think he's barraging, but I don't want to find out. He didn't look like he was barraging, but... Oh, Christ! Oh, God, Petite. Good job not panicking. Oh, fuck! No, it's okay, I'm not getting barraged. I'm just getting sectopodded, which is a little bit less scary. Watch his second move. Sectopods get to shoot twice, right? Oh, he's gonna Overwatch. He's not on Overwatch. What did he do? Maybe this time he's barraging me. This time, let's try and move everybody if we can. Petite, inches from death on the left. Good stuff. Great, great stuff. She is definitely going to be coming back.
Moving.
And we will bring Zim left. Now, how can we deal with all this? Iku can't see the fucking sectopod yet anyway, so fucking kill this guy first, please. We need him dead. Good.
He's down.
Dead. Now, we need to start thinking about how we're going to get Iku in position to hit this sectopod. Maybe if I move left, I can do it. Meanwhile, I'm going to have to suppress this guy. Keep him pinned while Instinct goes in for the kill. And just a fascinating mission is in play right now. Kind of got to take the awkward way around because of that sectopod's potential to just jump down and drop on me and have a fun time. Okay, at this point I can probably cloak and dagger over here. Do a little bit of cloak and dagger work. If I move Cell to this position, right, and then also, yep, this might be able to work. Maybe. Or I could just run out into the open and ghost, then I'm guaranteed to have shot. If I could get Petite in position to throw a grenade, I could also get rid of that fern, which is honestly a lot of the problem. Maybe the Shredder will deal with the fern and I'll get eyes on him. As long as that fern goes away, I think I'll have eyes on him. But I mean, yeah, the other solution is I run here and I ghost. I could ghost twice, but then I have to be out in the open to ghost. Could work though. I could ghost this position twice. Shredder, bang, 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 ghost again. Bang, 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 bang. I probably actually killed the fucking thing. Yeah, let's just balls out and do it. Get out there and fuck the thing. Fuck the fucking fucker.
Moving to position.
I don't want to get rocket barrage, so boys. You know how you avoid an artillery barrage? You outrun it. That is now our plan.
Sir.
This is how we're gonna deal with the sectopod.
Let's do this.
With a very large cell. And with no one else making it to that ghost grenade in time, may as well just go ahead and ghost right away here. Behold, the power of stealth. Fantastic. Oh, Petite can actually blow up his cover on the left. That's really cute. Let's go with that. That's adorable. Let's blow up his cover like the little bitch he is. Alley-oop.
Eat this.
It's burning. Where will you be when your cover explodes? Let's go ahead and suppress. Poor little bitch.
Aye, aye.
We'll begin to try and get an angle on the sector pod, though. Oh, I have an angle now. Fantastic. Reload. Hold. Don't know where he's gonna go. And then we just have to stay ready over here. I'll just reload.
We're green to go.
Now there's the artillery barrage I was expecting. There it is. Particularly because he wasn't on Overwatch. Like I said, good to vacate the position. Whoa! That can happen? I actually didn't think you could... What are you doing? Oh god. He's moving towards me. I actually didn't think... fuck, he's calling my bluff. Now I can't engage him. I actually did not think that aliens could miss civilians. I need to save that guy because he just earned his freedom. Just go save particularly that guy right now. Before we do anything else, that guy has earned it. That man is a hero. Get out of here, guy.
You're safe. Now get moving.
He's like, holy shit, did you see me dodge it? It was like the Matrix.
Dead and gone.
And now, in true boss fight fashion, the only thing we have left to worry about at this point, I believe, is the sector pod. Of course it is. Of course it is. Why wouldn't it be? Really? So we're gonna need to get eyes on that, obviously.
In the Beagle.
We have to assume once again that it's possible he is making a barrage, but of course, with no sight, he had sight on these left guys, so we have to assume it's possible, although we shouldn't assume it is happening, we have to assume it is possible. So if I were to move to this position, right, and I were to chuck a scan up, what would you tell me, game? What would you tell me? I can't express to you, game, how important it is that we get eyes on this sector pod right now. It's really quite critical to get eyes on this sector pod right now. I must have... Game, I really must insist. XCOM, I really must insist that I have sight on this sector pod right now. No, I understand you don't want to give me sight. I'm seeing that. I'm just saying you need to give it to me. Fucking hell. Oh, there it was. Nice. The other one looked a little better, there. Perfect scan.
Eyes in the sky.
I really hate that he's queued up on this roof. It makes him really tough to deal with. He's just sitting in the open like he knows it's genius. I think that he actually cannot get past the guide rails. So he'd have to jump down here to engage me. Which currently is working in my favor. There's no telling how long it will continue to work in my favor. And we're gonna go to hide from the artillery barrages. He doesn't seem to be doing more barrages at this point, but he's also not overwatching, so he must be. And EQ cannot get the all-important disable on him right now, which is critical at this juncture. I kind of need to run and hide because I don't know, like it's just very difficult to know where he's barraging without having vision on him, and that's why it's so important to keep vision on him. But if I take advantage of the fact that he has to jump down where the railings are, I can charge up those stairs towards him, start to get eyes on him that way, or I could prep a breach with my scout, prep a ghost breach. Prep my ghost riding of the whip.
Already there.
We'll think about it.
Time to motor.
One thing's for sure, with as many people as possible, we want to change our position to somewhere new.
Aye aye, Commander.
Even with Scoop Man, yes, even with Scoop Man. Because if he's getting artilleryed, that's not going to be fun. That's going to be even less fun than usual. And then probably just run EQ back, because it's the only place he can hide. Okay, what's his move? No barrage. Swim towards my troops. Will he just attempt to charge me over here? Yep, looks like it. Well, we know he didn't artillery barrage this turn. We also know where he is. He's cooped up on this position. We can probably prep to take him down next turn if we set this up right. Yeah, I'd say we can prep this to take him down now. Everyone can charge up and be ready on the pipe. And we're going to assault the fuck out of him. Exploiting the fact that he currently... that he currently cannot see us and cannot get artillery barrage on us. We're going to exploit that to its limit. We will push it to the limit, if you will. We will walk along the razor's edge. I won't look down. I will keep my head, etc. Scoopman, depressingly slow here, unfortunately. He might actually be able to make it up next turn. But we need to prep everybody to be ready to try and take this thing down next turn, or at least as many people as possible.
Already there.
Can even go up on the roof to keep tabs on him that way.
Moving to designated position.
I know he's like right there. I need to assume that the fun is about to just be beginning.
That's affirmative.
Running.
Position confirmed.
What's he doing up there?
Shh. You hear that?
We don't have eyes. He's coming over. Oh Christ, who can he see? Can you see anyone? Alright, we're out of vision. People are somewhat in position to move up here. Where is he again? This fucking pod, he's right there. Right there, so I should be able to move to this position with no problem.
Copy that.
Even if he is on Overwatch. Can't see him. Okay, that's fine.
In Bewegung.
Okay, he can see me, but he's not on Overwatch, which is good. But it does kind of hamstring my choices this turn, because obviously if I stay on the roof, I need the ghost. But there he is. We can assume he might be trying to do an indoor artillery strike right now, which is about as stupid as it sounds, but he's welcome to try. I'm going to get people in position here, and we're going to prepare to take this thing down.
Got it, moving.
Let's do this.
This is going to be a very interesting takedown. That is for sure.
Moving out. Begebe mich auf Position.
Where can Scoopman move to? Scoopman's move thing is all fucked up. So I can hit that rear thing. So Scoopman can move to there, that's no problem. That'll give him some cover for next turn. Like I said, ghost grenades, they're pretty useful. I would recommend them. And poor Riku just cannot, like, get in position here, unfortunately. He just can't really get in position. I'm probably just gonna move him back.
Double time.
Can't really get in the position here. Instinct can come in and get ghosted, but the thing of Instinct is, if I ghost him and he sits there and CCS triggers, he's in a lot of pain. So instead,
rolling.
Because CCS will take him out of stealth without my say-so. So instead, we might just hunker there. Smoke and Mirror's ghost gonna prove its worth here as we chuck out another ghost grenade. And just like the chrysalid mama, focus fire is the name of the game. Here it comes. Here comes the fun. It's coming towards us. It's coming straight for us. Here it comes. That's gonna make it harder to shred. It's actually charging me right now. Kind of scary. Now if I shred it... Oh, and I've got to move because... the fucker, it knows. Because now if I don't move, the explosion will blow everyone up too. Which I don't really want. So... called my bluff. Well played. Now everyone's going to scurry in different directions as we face this thing.
That's
affirmative. Oh, holy shit! Fuck! That means Cell can't engage it! Cell cannot engage it this turn. Poor. Very poor.
That's affirmative.
Oh my god, this is terrifying.
Moving.
Move, fuckers, move!
Bin.
Holy shit! Holy shit!
On the move. Off them big.
Okay. First, step one, apply some chem. Start stacking your debuffs, just like you're playing World of Warcraft at home, kids. Step two, keep stacking your debuffs. Do not stop stacking your debuffs yet. It's not time for that yet. Keep stacking your fucking debuffs.
Fire
close range, CQB RPG, do it, Organ. Right in its stupid face. You see how I told him to fire beyond it, but he just shot it in the face? He's like, Commander, you don't have to micromanage me. I know how this is done. Holo targeting. Stack your buffs for your own party. And now, this thing's just starting to look a little bit pathetic, isn't it? Go on, Zim. Show him what you think of it. That's damn right.
The operation was a success.
And in a finale that even Michael Bay couldn't have scripted better, the explosion as everyone scrambles for cover. Holy shit, what the fuck is that thing? Bow, 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 bow. Explosion wipes out all their cover as it finally goes down. And they all just stand there like, Jesus Christ, what the fuck? And that was Operation Dying Smoke. And that might have been the last hurrah before our Exalt base assault. I am not deterred. I'm still going down for that. Let's get back to base. Alright, Petite, a painful wound, 31 days out. My engineers are feeling the heat lately. Extra conditioning would have saved her from that much woundage. I think on your standard missions, extra conditioning is just the way to go. I regret not having it on more of my engineers. They're just so frail. Even in heavy cover, you just can't leave them not babysat. They're just so frail about extra conditioning. But everyone else makes it out unscathed. Completely unscathed. And yeah, that was an interesting mission, I tell you what. Unfortunately, panic has still increased in India by, well, a lot. But they're not leaving the council territory just yet, which is a bonus. Now I'm left here wondering how am I going to make enough footage space to carry on, because that was quite a long one, but leave it to me, and I'll be back and we'll be carrying on. Alright, we shall be continuing on, seeing if Exalt raids my bank account before I'm ready for them. Hopefully not. Never done this before, so... stranger things have happened. You know, it could happen. The Exalt cell apparently just went missing. Yes, I will take 3 scientists, thank you. I have tons of... I got a fucking... Where'd you get that sectoid? I'm fucking all over the place. We got 3 scientists from Canada, which is a really good deal. The Exalt cell just went into hiding. So that should give me... I should have more than enough time here. We'll see as we go. I don't know how it works. You're a failure, WMC. Why? Why would you do this to me? Why? Yeah, fucker. I'm gonna need you to get back in the tube and learn Science-Piration, okay? Okay, good. Bring in the next one. Prowler! I know you took a crit wound. I still... Oh, Prowler, for God's sake, I still need you fucking... Oh my God. Alright, fine. Well... Who else can I take instead? Maybe Squint? No, just stick him back in there because he has to learn sometime. He has to learn sometime. You get back in the tube, you fucking learn Hyper Beam. What was the chance? He's got a 29% because of his crit rune. We'll leave him till later. He really is having trouble there. Maybe we can send Squint in. And Squint can do a bit of psychic-ing. Yes. Big like psychicking. Although I'm gonna have to pull her out, of course, if things go wrong. So I'll probably want to stick Mind Fray onto Squint to back up my assault having Mind Fray, and that'll be two Mind Frays across the squad, plus a whole lot of Science-Piration. Should be like three Science-Pirations. In Beta 15, I'd probably take Neural Feedback on the JC Lewis Pariah build, which is a really good idea, which he's thought through very much. But apart from that, yeah, I think I'm gonna take Mind Fray on good old Squint. And it's 37%. It isn't that good either. Squint. Oh, cause Squint got critically wounded. Can someone raise their hand if they have not been critically wounded and they are psychic eligible? No, I think not. Is he? No, you got crit wounded at the start. Yes, but I don't want you to be one. Drake. Shut up, not now. Later, after the Exalt op. Wow, okay, I guess Burns, like, there's no point doing Burns like it right now. Fuck it! Fuck it, Prowler, you're back in! Or Squint, I guess. Nah, fuck it, Prowler's back in. He's gonna learn sometime. 29%, woo! Keep scanning. Captain Medve has completed gene modification. Captain Medvay is now a man of iron of his own skin, hyperreactive pupils, and neural damping. Let's just say Medvay is, yes, he's a very strong man now. He is literally made of steel at this point, I think. What else we got for you? Have we got any more people you want to chuck in the gene mod tube right about now?
I appreciate your efforts to support the research team, Commander. I've already put the new recruits to work in the lab.
Who else would we like to gene mod here? Oh, should the jumpy legs again? 7 days. Those would have been actually pretty good on the Exile HQ, but I don't have the time at this point. Who else could get jumpy... not jumpy legs. Who else could get gene mods? Squint would be a good candidate for the jumpy legs, honestly. Because she can jump, hit, and run. She's actually going to be a great candidate for that. But who else? Maybe I'll just hold off on gene mods for right now. Because everyone here kind of needs to be on rotation right now. So we might just let the gene mod stuff lie for a second.
Contact detected.
Okay, no more missions. We're like literal days away. No more missions. And yeah, I know, there must be a mission. Get him, Slash.
We're
just literal days away from the base assault. Just a couple days away.
You're in strike range. No joy here.
God, Urban. Almost took you the fuck out. Alright, Freebird. Freebird! Doesn't have to be a mission if it gets away. Nah.
We have eyes on the bandit.
Nah, we're taking this thing down, bruh.
Approaching target.
One shot. Yeah, no mission! Usually that's bad, but right now that's good because I want to do the exile base assault. Yeah! Yeah, USA! Okay. Yes. Oh, it's like a day off. That's a terrible deal. Hey! Aww, little sweetheart. Of course, Gamer didn't disappoint me.
He's a good psychic sniper. He's a good psychic sniper. You're a good psychic sniper. I'm gonna build you a neural gun link, and you're never gonna miss again. We're gonna forget that even happened that one time, those two times. I don't know how many times. I've already forgotten, see? Oh, Gamage! First try! Never miss. Alright, well, Gamage's got Psy Inspiration. More importantly, Gamage can now wield the neural gun link scope if I build one. And why wouldn't I? Because now I can stack even more aim on my sniper. That is handy. So for $64, 8 Illyrium, 3 alloys, 8 meld, and 1 scope. Ah, it takes an extra scope, but I think I have a scope to spare. I can now have a neural gun link, which is a very, very good thing. Build though. I'm going to... actually... maybe wait on that. I'll cancel him if I don't need him. Maybe actually that might not work out because I might need the scope on the exalt base ray, but I'll just cancel it and build it afterwards if I need it for that. Okay, we're so close. Oh, no, wait. And someone else has to go back into the Psy Labs to take Gamage's spot. She just gave up. Thanks, Gamage. Morgan isn't coming on the op. Morgan could become a psychic. Organ's coming on the op. Morgan and Organ. I never even noticed that before. Gunner Kong. Kung Tut? Nah. I'm going to need assaults to be ready because two of my assaults are getting fatigued on this operation that's about to happen. Maybe it could be Squint now. Maybe it could be Squint's turn. Or, how long is Verid out for? Wow, Verid's only out for a day. We could do Kung Tut. We could potentially do Kung Tut here. Then we can put the neural gun link on him as well, which would be really good. Okay. What's his chances? 40%? Okay. We'll take him out if we need him. Kung Tut gonna become a little psychic boy. We're just counting the day here. Just one more day. The longest day, if you will.
Commander, we've got another transmission coming in from the council.
God damn it. What the fuck?
Excellent. We look forward why? To seeing your progress.
Why, God, why? Okay, it is the bridge bomb disposal, which is quite a toughie as well. We'll need to deploy a squad to investigate. You bet it. You bet we will. I'll transmit any additional intel once they hit the ground. I just want to do this exalt base assault, man. I just want to do this base assault.
We are confident that you will handle
this. I've been wanting to do it for a long time.
Discretion.
Who is even going to be ready for this? AO is actually an hour off gene labbing, so AO could come and then we could exhaust AO, which would be good. But I have Volatile to take on this mission as well, so it's not actually necessary. In fact, I have a lot of people who are pretty much good to go. And then after this mission, this is definitely the last mission before the assault because 20 hours on Kilroy. Drake is ready, so Drake can come on this mission if I need an assault of her skills. But I don't think I'll need her bioelectric on this operation, so Instinct can come instead. Yeah. Well, let me gear up the squad for the bomb mission. Actually, sorry about that awkward long pause. I'm probably going to cut and then work out who I need to take, and then cut again, and I'll show you who I have to fatigue skip for. You get the drill, just wait! Alright, I've got my team pretty much picked. Volatile's my infantry. It's important to note how long we have to wait here, so 2 hours for Cell. Wait, yeah, Cell is coming on this off, I'm pretty sure. Isn't she? Was I taking her on the base assault? Hang on. Anyway, okay, so my base assault team was Organ, Hypergeek, Kilroy, AWO, Medvay, that's 5, Daishi, yes, Daishi, which is now going to be DSM, who's going to double dip. I'm going to double dip DSM. She's going on this mission as well. DSM's going on this one. Hunter, the medic, Cell was my other gunner in my notes here. Drake and Fraggy. Maybe what I could do is instead of taking Cell, I can take Medvay and take Iku instead. Yes. Iku's gonna go on the operation after all. I'm gonna trust in the inner zone. Cell can go on this one, which means the longest person we have to wait for, as I was saying, before I was really interrupted by myself, is Stoli. Libido Stoli at 11 hours. We have 15 hour response time. so these are all possible. The most important thing is to take everyone out of the deployment screen, because the reason we lost South Africa way back in the campaign is because when you leave people on the deck here, they don't lose fatigue. So I was waiting for Zim to wake up and get rid of her fatigue, and it never happened. So we just have to skip for Stoli. Frightening as it is to keep slicky. There we go. Okay, perfect. Now, as I was saying, bomb bridge.
Excellent. We look forward to seeing your progress.
Allow me to gear up my squad, and we shall be right along on this trifling matter. Alrighty, well, this is my team. What do we got? We got a pair of ghost grenades on DSM again, the clutch maker. Gamage coming along for her first psychically augmented op. No neural gun link for her this time, unfortunately. But she does have the scope and the medkit, which is fine. We needed someone to bring a medkit, and the assault bring another medkit. Again, not bringing a medic on the bomb mission because you need to go. You need to kill fast and defuse nodes. Bringing the LMG on cell. Maybe not the best choice on a bomb mission in one way, but on the other, this is the bridge map. Now, the bridge has terrible line of sight, yes. I'm aware of this. It has awful line of sight. But if you can get down the right avenue, it can also have very long line of sight if you play it right. So hopefully I'm going to be able to position Cell in some of those sweet spots where the LMG will actually be superior. Because the other thing about bridge is it doesn't have a lot of covering firing ports for you to fire from. It doesn't have, like, a lot of... There's a lot of no man's land that kind of keeps you from moving up easily of a lot of your troops. So honestly, I feel like the LMG will be less awkward for the gunner, not more, if that makes sense. I feel like being able to fire that a little bit longer might be the difference as opposed to moving up and, you know, not being able to shoot anyway. We'll see. I'm sure it'll bite me at some point. And then J-Bals and Stoli. J-Bals opting actually to bring the second rocket instead of the second shredder as per usual. Because this map is full of explosive car cover, I don't want to get embroiled in a firefight that I can't blow my way out of. So if mutons try to stop me from blowing up the bomb by hunkering behind a Toyota, I'm just going to blow that Toyota up with a rocket. I'm going to say, you know what, I got more rockets for later. I got rockets for all you, I got grenades for all you. Stoli of the extra conditioning is the perfect engineer for this mission. Yeah. So that's really it. That's the plan. I brought two assaults instead of an extra medic, and we're just going to go hard in the motherfucking paint. I have hyperactive pupils on volatile bullfrog, which may prove handy, but really the onus is not going to be on the infantry in this mission. It's going to be on our assaults, our explosives, probably gamage our sniper covering us as we move up, and the covering fire of Cell, and of course those ghost grenades if we need them. Let's hit launch, let's get out there, and let's take down this last hurrah as the sectoids and exalt throw the bomb mission at me in the mission store before I finally push through the tide and get to that exalt base assault. Let's go. Oh, wait, hang on. I almost forgot. I gotta take my picture. It's the worst of volatile because... Oh, fuck, these two. You're gonna watch a little mini game here. Okay. See? Volatile's name moved. See how hard it makes it? Okay, I'm just gonna split... I'm gonna have to composite them together. Okay. I got my picture for the mission, which you're about to see in a second. Now let's go.
Touching down.
We'll be deploying to Russia for this one.
Okay. So, they're trying to blow up St. Petersburg, the bastards, and they're going to take out St. Petersburg's Golden Gate Bridge. I think that's what it's called. I'm pretty sure that sounds familiar. Join me next time for Operation Bloody Star. Until then, have a good one.